America. Police say that 11 of the burglaries have occurred in the past 3 weeks, including three on Monday. And most disturbing to police here at Southeast District Headquarters, the fact that these burglars don't seem to be fear much of anything, including a confrontation with the homeowners. Willow Oaks Subdivision, no longer the sleepy little neighborhood on the city's far southeast side.
These are the known burglaries in this neighborhood for the past 3.5 weeks.
Over the past 3 weeks, burglars have targeted at least 11 homes in the neighborhood, including the home of Christopher Clark. They broke in at night and stole cash, electronics, and his SUV.
Kind of found the wriggler, realized that it was gone, called the police, and realized someone broke in the house while we were in the house asleep. So it kind of scary situation there.
In some cases, police say the victims made it easy for the perpetrators. They left doors and windows unlocked and garage door openers inside the vehicles. Burglaries can and do happen everywhere. Most unsettling, the trend of home break-ins at night with sleeping homeowners inside.
That's scary when the homeowner's in the house. Now, that is scary. Thank God for my little dogs.
It's very concerning, obviously. The fact that someone is bold enough to enter in someone else's house while they're sleeping overnight is concerning to everybody.
News of the break-ins has swept through the subdivision. While many of the burglaries occurred a couple of weeks ago, three more occurred on Monday, and police and residents alike are at a loss to explain why.
Maybe because we've got left our guard down. It's been so quiet, maybe they think, well, they're not looking for it. But we're on our guard now. That's for sure.
Metro Police urge residents to lock all doors and windows. Keep outside lights on during the nighttime hours. Document serial numbers and photograph all valuables. And don't leave the garage door opener in your vehicle.
I wasn't proponent of guns, but let's just say I am now.
The crime lab has recovered fingerprints in a couple of the break-ins. That's allowed them to identify at least two suspects. Police say they could make some arrests yet this week.